Hey, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and I wanted to talk to you about extracting some data from your PDFs. I just did a tutorial on how to do some basic extraction as an introduction, but if you ever start doing some data extraction from your PDFs, you want it to be anchor-based. It's the only way to really make it work with multiple files. So that's what I want to talk about here. In the next tutorial, I'm going to talk about doing data extraction on tabular data. And if you put the two together, I think you'll really know how to work with PDF files in UiPath. I'm going to kick this off by creating a new process project, and I'll call it PDF extract. And as that project is being created, I just want to show you the PDF that I'm going to pull some data out of. You notice that I've got the invoice number, the date over here. I've also got the total. I want to pull that data out of this PDF file using anchors. Now, one thing I should point out, there's tabular data on here, like that mailing address is tabular. The line items here in the orders is tabular. And then there's properties, there's name value pairs like invoice and the invoice number, date and the date number. If you want to pull out tabular data, you have to do that through data scraping. I've got a tutorial on that, that's one of the next ones. If you want to pull out the name value pairs, the best way to do it is with the anchor tag. And so that's what I'm going to demonstrate here. I'm going to pull out the invoice number, the date, and the total, and I'm going to do it all through an anchor activity. Now, to kick this whole thing off, I need to actually get the name and folder of that file. It's in a folder called orders here. So I'm just going to copy that and then paste that name in, and I'm going to paste it into a process starting activity. So open up the main window, look for the process creation activity. There's something called start process. I'm going to drop that on there as my first step. And the process that I want to run is whatever process is going to open up that invoice A1A PDF that I just showed you. Now, along with kicking off that process, we need to attach the Adobe PDF window to this process so that we can interact with it. In order to do that, you look for the attach window command. So I'm going to click the attach window command down here. Now it does say, what screen do you want to attach? And the easiest way to do that is to kind of move UiPath Studio off to the left and put your PDF to the right, click indicate window on screen, and then just click on your PDF file, and the tool realizes, okay, it's that PDF Adobe Acrobat viewer that it wants to, that we want to use when we go through this PDF file. Now, by the way, in the selector, they always specify the actual name of the file. I don't actually need that here, and that can cause problems later if you're looping through a bunch of files and one of the files obviously won't have that name. It'll cause a problem. So I like to deselect that. It's not necessary for this particular exercise, but it's a good idea. Now, what I want to do is I want to grab some information here. I want to grab that invoice number, the invoice date, and the invoice total. I'm going to grab that information. I'm going to need some variables. So I'm going to create those right off the bat. So I got invoice number, invoice date, and invoice total, all of type string. I'll have scope throughout the entire sequence. Those will come handy in this exercise. Make sure you got those variables declared. And then the first thing I'm going to grab is this invoice number, A1A101. And I'm going to do it by telling the tool, hey, on every single invoice, there'll be a section on the page where it says invoice number. Now, the invoice number is going to change from time to time. So I want you to look under where it says invoice number, which will always be there, and give me the value associated with it. And you do that by adding something in called an anchor activity. So there's the anchor base activity. I'm going to drop that in here. And it's got two parts to it. Where's the anchor? And what's the text that you want to get based on that anchor? And to fill in the anchor, you go find element. Let me see if I can, where is find element? It's actually under UI automation, element find. So I'm going to go find element. And again, it says, what element are you looking for? So again, click that button. Say I'm looking for something relative to the invoice number. It says, okay, that's cool. It says, what do you want to do once you've found that? And I'm going to say, I'm going to get some text that's associated with it. It says, well, show me what text you want. And again, I'll click on that link and I'll say, well, it's actually the text that's right underneath it. That text right there, A1A001. And it looks like everything is running swimmingly. Now, one thing I will say, this anchor base tries to guess what text you're interested in, and it doesn't always guess it right. That anchor invoice number is above the string that I want. So what you should always do is explicitly state in your anchor base where that anchor is positioned. In this case, invoice number is positioned above the variable, above the data that I want. So in anchor position, you say that the anchor is above or the anchor is on top of the element that we're after. Not on top. On top means actually the same cell. Top means just above it. There's two options there that are kind of similar. See, on top and top. We want top. Okay, so that is going to give us our, what's it going to do? That's going to give us our invoice number. And if you want, you can even write that out. So you can say, hey, the invoice number is, and then plus invoice number. And that should print out what the invoice number is. And then we can follow these steps right through and get the invoice date. And so again, that's going to be exactly the same. It's just going to be different. So we grab the anchor base activity, throw it on, add the find element, throw it on, add the get text, throw it on. In this case, I'm going to get the invoice date. So the value of the get text is going to be invoice date. Then I go through the process of associating those two elements with the fields that I want. So I'm running out of space here on the page. But what is the anchor element? Indicate the element inside the window for the anchor that I'm going to be looking for. Well, it's that date colon word there. And then what text do we want? Well, I want the text that's right underneath it. That's the text right there. Okay, and that all looks like it's working properly. Now again, the anchor is above, the anchor is on top of the data that I'm getting. And so in that case, we want to change the anchor base there to indicate that we're going, that the anchor is on top of the field that we're looking for. Notice it kind of switches the way it's structured on the page too. I always think that's kind of cool. Nice little attention to detail, as they say. And now I've got one more. I want to get the total. So I'm going to go anchor base over here. I'm going to do a find element. I'm going to do a get text. The get text, oh, I didn't mean to hit that, excuse me. The get text field is going to initialize the invoice total. So I'll specify that get text updates that as part of its output. And of course, I've still got the steps to find the element and get the text. So let me see, do the find element for the total, indicate element, and I'll click over here. There's the total field. And then again, it'll ask, what is the text that you want? So I'll click on that $115 value. And again, it looks like total is on top. And so the last thing that I need to do here is specify that the anchor position is top. That gets me through the anchor base thing, and then I guess I can always write the line out there and say, hey, the total is plus invoice total. Okay, well, all this looks good. I always like to make sure, you know, I got things in double quotes. I often forget to do that. Make sure that I've got each variable for the getter pointing to a value. And why is there no value there? So that get text should point to invoice number. So it looks like I did mess something up there. Make sure that you've got that specified. So get text for there goes to invoice number. This get, well, that get text goes to invoice date. And then this get text goes to invoice total. And you know what? I never printed out the invoice date. Gee, that wasn't very thoughtful of me. So I'm just going to add a write line after the invoice date. And date is invoice date. Okay, and that looks pretty handsome there. There's the, well, that doesn't look too visually appealing, but it gives you a bit of an idea there of what's going on. But yeah, we kick off the process. We load the PDF. We associate it with Acrobat Reader. And then we, based on anchors, get the invoice number, the invoice date, and the invoice total. Okay, well, I'm going to run this, see what happens. Click Save, click Run. Oh, there's a validation error. Looks like, oh, I had an underscore instead of a plus there. Eh, silly me. Okay, save that again and then run. Opens up the file, does the extract, and then here you can see down at the bottom, the invoice number is A1A001, the date is 01/2020, the total is 115, and that maps exactly to everything I've got on the form, A1A, 2020, and 115. And there you go. That's how you do anchor-based extraction of data in your PDFs. If you enjoyed this tutorial, why don't you head over to theserverside.com. I've got all sorts of tutorials and articles over there about enterprise software development. If you're interested in my personal antics, you can follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and subscribe on YouTube.